Now we're joined by Captain Edgardo Diaz. He's the Deputy Director General of the Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines. Captain Diaz, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Ron.
We have several issues to talk to you about. First, there have been reports coming out claiming that the budget for the maintenance and for the improvements of the air traffic management system of the NAIA was used for other projects. Now, we understand that you just took office this year or last year, July 2022, but will you be able to tell us if these reports are true? Have you looked into this?
What I can say, Ron, is that yes, that is true. We just assumed office. And regarding that matter, I would not like to discuss that. That is probably one of the topics that we will be discussing. Whether that is true or correct is something that I cannot confirm right now.
But you are looking into that?
Yes, yes. That came up, and I am sure that that will be part of the agenda in our next meetings.
In your next meeting and possibly in a Senate hearing or a hearing at the House of Representatives, you'll be able to talk to you'll be able to talk about that?
I think so.
Okay. Yes. We'll leave it at that first. Now, in a recent press briefing, it was revealed that the UPS equipment, which it was the UPS equipment that initially caused the damage, which then led to other problems in the backup system. Now, yesterday we had CAAP Director General Captain Manuel Tamayo revealing that the system is outdated. It was started to be installed 2010, finished 2018. But did that system being outdated have anything to do with what caused the glitch?
Right now, we are continuing our investigation. And we are looking all of the possible reasons why we had that power failure. Mm-hmm. UPS, or the uninterrupted power supply, is one of the equipment that we are looking at. Initially, in our troubleshooting, or the troubleshooting being done by our technical personnel, our engineers, points towards the direction of the UPS. Mm-hmm. That is now the subject of the investigation. We are looking at it. Maybe it is the part of the problem or the main problem, and we will know that as soon as we get all the data.
So you are still in the middle of investigating what possibly caused this, right?
That is correct, Ron.
At this point, has an external attack or sabotage been ruled out already?
That is also a question that was asked. DICT is working with us. But in our initial assessment, this electrical power and all the equipment are all hardware. Hmm. We do not have software to run our electrical system. So though we are not ruling that out, there is the possibility is more of the mechanical component. No? Mm. That is what I can say about that right now.
Okay. Now, we just want to double check with you as well. Are all systems, including the backups, working properly now, 100%?
100%. That is the situation now. We are running everything. All systems are working well.
Nothing needs repairs anymore. Nothing needs to be replaced.
That is part of the investigation and the checking. All the instruments and equipment that supports our system are now being checked and double checked so as to prevent another situation as like what happened.
Right. I was going to ask that. With all systems at 100% at this point, can the CAAP confidently say, that the situation that happened on New Year's Day won't happen again?
It happened on New Year's Day. And with regard to your question, we are doing everything to make sure that all our equipment, our system will function well and that it will not fail. That is why the checking is ongoing, the backup systems being checked, the redundancy being checked, so that we'll have a system that will work and not encounter a problem that we encountered last time.
Okay, a couple of more issues, Captain. A transport group and other groups as well, as maybe you've heard Bayan Munas Neri Colmenares encouraging affected passengers to file damages against the CAAP because of what happened. We want to get your reaction to that.
Well, that is something that we also heard. And as of this time, I cannot give you any answer to that question. I am sure that that will also be discussed.
Okay, finally, Captain, days before the NEA glitch, we had a transport secretary, Jaime Bautista, saying that the government will be pushing for the privatization of the NEA. Of course, that includes all its operations, including air traffic control. What are your thoughts on that? Are you in favor of that? Do you think it would be beneficial for the main gateway as well as for the public, that privatization?
Well, for me, CAAP is a regulatory body. Mm-hmm. We should be concentrating on regulations, the compliances of the different sectors involved in the aviation industry. I think it is a right direction to take.
Yes, that would be for the government agency. CAAP, of course, is a government agency, but for the privatization of NEA, including its operations, do you think it would be better? It would be beneficial?
NEA, or you're referring to the air traffic controllers?
NEA and its air traffic control management. Not the system, but including the people operating it.
Right now, MIAA is an authority, you know, so it is being run by another entity. CAAP, we handle air traffic service for MIAA. Right now, as I've said, we should probably concentrate on regulatory matters rather than doing the air traffic service. So I think it is one of the options that we should study, whether to privatize air traffic service or not. That is going to be discussed more, and a study should be conducted whether that will be more beneficial towards the service to our people.
Okay. One more thing, sir. We did mention that the Senate and the lower house may be looking into this travel chaos that happened and the failure of the systems. But this early, have you probably come up with recommendations you would want the lawmakers to hear and possibly implement for the future?
Right now, as we speak, another meeting is ongoing. Actually, I just came from there, and everything is being discussed. No, moving forward, what should we do, or what do we need? No, right now, that is being discussed. So, I cannot tell you much about that. That is being all coming from the different sectors. No, there are so many people giving their thoughts, and we welcome all the suggestions. And probably we will be coming up with recommendations as to how we can improve our system and our service.
Okay. Captain Edgardo Diaz of the CAAP, thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.